Bill H., any thoughts about the glymphatic system in the brain as coined by Dr. Matthew Walker in Why We Sleep, which is the brain's method of removing toxins during sleep? I will say this, and then I'll hand it over to the expert. I love that book, and I read it probably 3 or 4 times. Great book. So, David, comments?
It's a favorite subject of mine, actually. I read the original work out of the University of Rochester some years ago from Jeffrey Iles. He was the original PI on some of this work. And this kind of touches back to what I was mentioning before about how the rest of our body has a lymphatic system to remove and to cleanse from toxins and whatnot. But the brain doesn't participate in that normal lymphatic system. What the glymphatic system does is it relies upon a deep restorative sleep to relax the gap junctions between the cells in the brain. And when that happens, it allows the circulation of cerebral spinal fluid to eliminate some of the toxins that we have in our brain. You see this in particular, and the research originally was done in mice that were modified to have Alzheimer's disease, and you see an accumulation of tau protein when the mice don't get a restorative sleep. Having a good sleep pattern, having good sleep hygiene, means that you allow those gap junctions to relax slightly, and that allows the circulation of fluid that removes the toxins. Fantastic finding. And it's continuing to be explored more and more as we understand more about how the brain eliminates the toxins that develop through the course of the day. That's why it's so important to get a good night's sleep, a good restorative sleep, as it allows our brain to detoxify.
And I've always had problems with sleeping. I'm going in the reverse direction. Most people tend to get worse sleep as they age. I'm getting better sleep. And I've always done, the most common thing about sleep is just the simple sleep hygiene, making sure you don't have technology with you, make sure you don't have noise. I learned from that book to actually get eye shades, these little eye things to put over it, because there's a huge difference. Our eyelids do let a lot of light through.
Want to avoid the blue light.
Avoid the blue light, which you see on these devices. And these devices now, as a result of that, have some blue light impacts. I've changed mine to, at night, 6 or 8 o'clock, you can see it sometimes where it changes from more of a blue tint to more of a brownish or beige tint. A couple of things that have helped me recently. Number one, I've greatly increased my resistance training, especially in my thighs, the larger muscle groups, and that has helped with sleep. So this, the hygiene, the large muscle groups, and again, go back to that respirate, slowing that breathing down and doing some other things in terms of breathing and airway control. Major improvements. So I'd like to talk with you a minute about the webinar. People don't understand what the webinar is. It's actually a great way to get some access to healthcare that you're just not going to get any other way. You actually get the lab tests yourself at a local lab, a Quest lab near you, for the inflammation panel and the OGTT and the insulin survey. These are things, inflammation and prediabetes, that your doctor just does not know about. And here's the thing. Harvard Health and many others have said, look, sudden death is not always so sudden. The Hollywood picture that it's a bolt out of the blue is not realistic. It's more like real lightning preceded by clouds, wind, and rain. Stop that metabolic storm before the lightning strikes. And here's where that metabolic storm comes from. It's inflammation, and it has to do usually with prediabetes. So again, we actually get labs, we go over them in the webinar, and then you can start finding out how you can prevent that heart attack others said that you couldn't even predict. We can show you how. Thanks.